O you who have believed, when you contract a debt for a specified term, then write it down. And let a scribe write it down between you in fairness. Let no scribe refuse to write it as Allah has taught him. So let him write, and let the one who has the obligation, meaning the one who's taking the loan, let him dictate. And let him fear Allah and be honest. Let him fear Allah, his Lord, and not leave anything out of it. But if the one who has the obligation, meaning the one who's taking the loan, the one who has to dictate, if he is of limited understanding or weak or unable to dictate himself, then let his guardian dictate in justice and bring to witness two witnesses from among your men. And if there are not two men available, then a man and two women from those whom you accept as witnesses. So that if one of the women errs, then the other can remind her. Why two women? The reason is also given. That if one makes a mistake, then the other will just help her. Because we as women, what do we like? Support always. So much so that even if women have to go to the bathroom, what do they want? A public bathroom, that their friend should come along with them. Just stand outside while I use the restroom. This is something that is within women. That we like company, we like support. So here also, in a courtroom, when there's a serious matter, if a woman is brought in to testify, then her friend comes in with her. So that in case she makes a mistake, then her friend can remind her. But if she doesn't make a mistake, then the friend doesn't have to do anything at all. Then the testimony of that woman is sufficient. So over here we learn about the dain, loan, that when a loan is being contracted, loan is being taken, then this thing should be written down and witnesses should also be brought. And let not the witnesses refuse when they are called upon, and do not be too wary to write it, whether it is small or large, for its specified term. That is more just in the sight of Allah, and stronger as evidence, and more likely to prevent doubt between you, except when it is an immediate transaction which you conduct among yourselves. Meaning if it's an immediate contract, transaction, which is concluded right there and then with cash payment, then it is not necessary to record that transaction. It is not necessary that witnesses be brought. For then there is no blame upon you if you do not write it. And take witnesses when you conclude a contract, meaning when there is an official business transaction, then what should you do? Call witnesses and let no scribe be harmed or any witness. No one should be harmed. For if you do so, indeed it is grave disobedience in you. And fear Allah. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ وَيُعَلِّمُكُمُ اللَّهِ And Allah will teach you. How is it that a person learns? When he fears Allah. And Allah is knowing of all things. And if you are on a journey and cannot find a scribe, then a security deposit should be taken. And if one of you entrusts another, then let him who is entrusted discharge his trust faithfully. And let him fear Allah, his Lord. And do not conceal testimony. For whoever conceals it, his heart is indeed sinful. And Allah is knowing of whatever you do. لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ To Allah belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is in the earth. وَإِن تُبْدُوا مَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ أَوْ تُخْفُوهُ يُحَاسِبُكُمْ بِهِ اللَّهِ Whether you show what is within yourselves or conceal it, Allah will bring you to account for it. فَيَغْفِرُ لِمَن يَشَاءُ Then He will forgive whomsoever He wills. وَيُعَذِّبُ مَن يَشَاءُ And He will punish whom He wills. وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ And Allah is over all things competent.